Watching a volcano erupt is one of the most fun and fascinating things a person can do. However, the lava flows a volcano produces can widely vary, ranging from a few inches thick to several feet in height to, on rare occasions, even more than 2,000 feet thick. And these lava flows have differing textures which are somewhat dependent on the composition of rock they contain. This video will discuss several types of lava flows, including Pāhoehoe, and other varieties. The first type of lava flow which can occur is known as Pāhoehoe. Pāhoehoe is a variety of typically basaltic composition or low silica lava that has a low viscosity. It is associated with volcanic eruptions that produce a low rate of lava effusion involving ropey masses of material which advance across the landscape. Thus, when Pāhoehoe cools, it leaves behind a ropey and largely smooth texture. Another type of low viscosity lava flow which commonly occurs is known as A'a. Per a direct quote from the US Geological Survey, A'a has a rough, jagged, and clinkery surface. A'a lava flows are associated with higher rates of lava effusion than their Pāhoehoe counterparts, with several A'a flows of this variety being witnessed during Mauna Loa's 2022 eruption. These lava flows commonly sound like breaking glass as they advance due to their overall nature. When A'a lava cools, it leaves behind trails of largely black volcanic rocks which are generally smaller than a foot in diameter, are quite jagged, and are piled on top of one another. When an effusive volcanic eruption occurs underwater, it often creates an unusual type of lava flow simply known as pillow lava. Pillow lava gets its name from the rounded chunks of material they create, which are often placed right next to each other in a dense assortment. They thus look sort of like fluffed up pillows. However, when an eruption has a higher silica content, like seen at most stratovolcanoes or volcanoes in general which erupt andesite or more viscous varieties of lava, a different type of lava flow is often created. Known as blocky lava, this variety of lava flow, when cooled, tends to form an assortment of many several foot wide blocks of material which are somewhat rough but have a slightly smoother appearance than A'a lava flows. Blocky lava flows can form thick lobes of material that can reach more than a mile in length, like seen at the remote Kanaga volcano within Alaska. Or, blocky lava might pile up in close proximity to its erupting vent, forming a tall lava dome. On rare occasions, blocky lava flows can even be more than 1,000 feet thick. If by chance you see a lava flow that contains chunks of obsidian, it is almost certainly a blocky lava flow. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.